A new study found that common household chemicals known as phthalates contribute to more than 100,000 deaths a year in adults aged 55 to 64. These premature deaths have known reasons, especially with heart disease. But this peer-reviewed study, published in the journal Environmental Pollution, also estimates an approximate 40 to 47 billion lost annually in economic productivity due to these deaths. What are these phthalate chemicals, aka plasticizers? Why are they toxic? And how can you minimize your exposure to them? In this video, I'm going to cover the main things that you need to know about these plasticizers, including what are the types of plasticizers or phthalates and where are they found. In the United States, phthalates are found pretty much everywhere. Take a walk in a store, for example, and chances are you'll see tons of products with these toxins in them. These include certain children's toys, clothing, food storage containers, shampoos, lotions, soaps, hairspray, and much more. These chemicals are so common that they're known as everywhere chemicals. Globally, we consume more than 3 million tons of phthalates a year, and some of them have been banned or restricted in children's toys, but are pretty common in food packaging, makeup, and other household items. There are two high-level categories of phthalates. There are the low molecular weight phthalates and the high molecular weight phthalates. So with the low molecular weight phthalates, they're often found in shampoos, lotions, personal care products. They act as binding agents and help to preserve the fragrance in these products. Now, the high molecular weight phthalates are ingredients in manufacturing plastics, like for flooring, also food wrap, and other applications. They help to soften the plastic. So why are these phthalates dangerous? Well, this new study is the first to link phthalates directly to death. The researchers used a nationally representative sample of 5,300 adults aged 20 and older. The lead author, Leonardo Tresand, he said, "Until now, we have understood that the chemicals connect to heart disease, and heart disease, in turn, is a leading cause of death, but we've not yet tied the chemicals themselves to death." Phthalates interfere with our body's hormones, so these chemicals have been known to lower testosterone levels, which low testosterone means many things, but one of those things is an increased risk of cardiovascular disease. People with a higher concentration of phthalates in their urine had a greater probability of dying from heart disease. Now, daily exposure to these chemicals causes a buildup of toxins and can induce oxidative stress. Now, this oxidative stress can lead to various issues like cell and tissue damage, premature aging, and chronic conditions such as obesity, both in children and adults. Not just obesity, but also diabetes, breast cancer, and thyroid cancer. Lab studies have also linked phthalates to endometriosis and even possibly infertility. It's important to note that this study did not find a higher risk of dying from cancer due to greater concentrations of phthalates. For this study, the researchers analyzed data collected from the U.S. National Health and Nutrition Examination Survey from 2001 to 2010. This survey was administered by the National Center for Health Statistics at the CDC. Now, during the survey, participants had provided urine samples to measure phthalate metabolite concentrations. How do we accumulate phthalates in our bodies? Phthalates can get into our bodies through our skin when we inhale them or when we eat them. Food is the main source of phthalate exposure. It can also happen when children crawl around and put their hands in their mouths after they touch things. So that's another way. Once phthalates enter our body, they're ultimately processed into metabolites, and those metabolites get excreted in our urine and our feces. Previously, researchers believed that phthalates cleared rapidly from our body by the means of making urine, and then that urine gets excreted, and these chemicals did not accumulate in our bodies for a very large amount of time. But further research has shown that this is not entirely true. While many phthalates do have short half-lives and can be eliminated from our bodies within 12 to 24 hours by means of urine and feces, some undergo further metabolism within our bodies before being expelled. And studies have found that certain metabolites of these phthalates, they end up in our sweat. So they're found in the sweat of participants, even if the chemicals were not detected in their urine. So this discovery means that there's a definite accumulation of phthalate metabolites in our tissues. So how do we avoid or prevent exposure to these phthalates? How do we prevent them from getting into our body? Unfortunately, it's currently impossible to completely avoid exposure to phthalates. They're used in hundreds, if not thousands, of products. Also, manufacturers are not required to list them on labels. But there are ways to reduce your exposure to phthalates, including avoid storing food in plastic containers, use stainless steel, glass, or ceramic instead, Don't heat food in plastic containers. Use fragrance-free body lotions, soaps, laundry detergents, and household cleaners. Avoid air fresheners. And reduce your intake of processed foods. Of course, this is easier said than done. Processed foods include any food that's been washed, cleaned, milled, chopped, heated, pasteurized, cooked, preserved, mixed, or packaged. Basically, this means anything that's not purchased in its natural state. This even includes spices, flavoring, salts, sugars, and added fats. So, of course, it's going to be more practical to try and switch to minimally processed or whole foods like vegetables and fruit, and avoiding fast food, avoiding deli meat, avoiding crackers, chips, breakfast cereal, frozen pizza, microwave dishes, and so forth. The other thing that you can do is wash your hands frequently with unscented soap. So your best bet is to try and eat more fresh food cooked at home. And studies have shown that people who dine out or order in had nearly 35% higher phthalate levels compared to people who ate at home when they cooked their own food. Now, apart from food itself, recycled cardboard used as food packaging has higher concentrations of phthalates than virgin cardboard. If phthalates are harmful, why are they still so common? Well, phthalate is a term that refers to a wide variety of chemicals, so while certain countries have banned a few phthalates, there's a lot more that can be done to protect our health. When it comes to phthalate use, the issue is more complex than just avoiding plastic containers. Even if you buy milk in a glass bottle, it may contain phthalates because the milk may have passed through phthalate-containing tubes at the processing plant. Even gloves that are part of the standard food handling and safety protocols have phthalates. DEHP, or DEP, is a prime example. DEP is the most common class of phthalates and is found in almost everything because it helps make plastic softer and more flexible. DEP can leach into liquids and foods that are packaged in plastic, particularly foods like milk, cream, cheese, seafood, and oils. It's also found in bottled water. It's also frequently used in medical devices like intravenous catheters, dialysis equipment, blood bags, transfusion tubes, and much more. While it's not absorbed through the skin, it can be absorbed in your mouth. So if you have contaminated hands and then you put things in your mouth, that's how it gets in. So as a result, hand washing with soap is an excellent way to get that DEP residue off your hands as long as it's a scent-free soap. Without a doubt, we need more research and regulations surrounding how these phthalates are used in plastics and identified on product labels. Many regulatory bodies worldwide have started to take action against the use of certain phthalates in toys. Still though, food packaging, makeup, shampoos, body lotions, and other cosmetics are not as regulated. For example, DEP has been banned in toys in the United States, Europe, Canada, Israel, Australia, and China. While Europe banned DEP and another phthalate, DBP, from cosmetics, the US FDA is yet to restrict them. And there's another huge hurdle when trying to regulate phthalates. While research is important, it can take many years before there's significant data linking a particular phthalate to potential health issues that it may impact. When DEP had been found to be toxic, it was quickly replaced by DINP and DIDP. These chemicals were considered safe at the time, but years later, studies showed that these chemicals can also have a negative impact on health. The American Chemistry Council, a group that represents chemicals, plastics, and chlorine in the United States, they responded that they believe the study holds several inaccuracies and that DIDP, DINP, and other high molecular weight phthalates have lower toxicity. Regardless, we need not only more research, but also stricter and clearer guidelines around how the overall class of phthalates is used and labeled. Otherwise, we'll continue to be exposed to a daily dose of toxicity from these toxins. The disease and death burden from this will only be known several years into the future. Are there safer alternatives to using phthalates? One of the main issues with phthalates is that they leach from their products into food, into water, and the environment. As we saw with regular exposure, they can accumulate in our bodies and lead to premature death from heart disease or other reasons. The biggest way to reduce the use of phthalates in various products is for consumers to drastically reduce our use of plastics. Apart from this, there are chemicals that work as plasticizers but don't leach out. There are phthalate-free inks and adhesives that can be used for printing and labeling. Polyethylene glycol is considered safer for use in cling wrap and food service gloves. Also, plastic gaskets on the underside of metal bottle caps and lids, even for glass jars, have safer plasticizer alternatives.